Alright, assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
May I know what's your name, sister?
My name is Pamela Kara.
Sister Pam, where are you from?
I'm originally from outside of Cleveland, Ohio, in the northern part of the U.S. near the Great Lakes.
MashaAllah.
This is where I grew up.
MashaAllah. And how long have you been Muslim?
Well, I've been Muslim about 12 years.
And how was, or what were you before you became Muslim? What church?
I was raised in a Protestant Methodist family, somewhat Episcopalian, somewhat Methodist, but primarily Protestant family.
Wow. And what made you to know Islam?
Well, actually, I think I was always looking for, my whole life, I was always looking for the truth. I was looking for something. I didn't really know what I was looking for, but when I became older, I married, and I was preparing to adopt a child, and the child was going to be from overseas, from a Muslim country, and I had been married, and I was still a Christian. I was married for 16 years, and my husband was a Muslim, and I was a Christian, and I didn't even become interested in finding anything out about Islam until we were starting to prepare to take this child into our home. And I started taking classes at the local masjid thinking I'm going to become a mom and I need to prepare or get some idea of what I'm going to be reinforcing or teaching this child. So this is how I first became interested, inshallah.
SubhanAllah, I mean, you're doing a great job also in raising a child. Is he an orphan also?
He was an orphan,
so
yes, he
was. You get more ajr also under
inshallah.
That, inshallah.
Now, inshallah.
So you were, from your studies, you got convinced. What was the, let me ask you a more specific question.
Okay.
Like, what is the thing that it really made you to look into Islam, and what was the thing that it really impressed you about Islam?
Well, actually, I started to go to the local masjid, and they had classes that the imam taught. And I remember arguing with the imam and telling him he really didn't know what he was talking about. And I was still very much, I wasn't really attached to anything, but I just really didn't believe quite what he was saying. So one of the gentlemen in the class asked me if I had a Quran, and I said, no, I didn't. And he gave me a Quran, and I read Surah Al-Fatiha, and that was enough.
Wow.
Just reading this surah, I felt, because the little voice said, you know, this is what you're looking for. This is the truth.
SubhanAllah.
And after just reading Surah Al-Fatiha, I knew that this is what I was looking for.
Wow, that's great. MashaAllah. And now you made your shahada. How do you see your life after Islam? Do you see much of difference, like before and after?
Not the same life, and not the same. I am not the same person. I cannot imagine, you know, not being a Muslim, not having Islam, not having the Quran or the Sunnah.
Right.
It's like taking a new pair of glasses and putting them on and seeing the world in the correct way.
SubhanAllah.
Because I my life prior to that was very much a life of confusion, you know, being raised as an American, being raised here, really not without any truth in our culture or foundation. It was like you're just confused,
right,
and you're searching and you're going from one situation to the next without any plan or any way to go. So once I took my shahada and became a Muslim and started reading more and learning more, learning to pray, it was just, there's no going back, there's only going forward. It's the very best thing I ever did in my life.
SubhanAllah, so you don't regret about what you're doing right now?
If it's the only thing I did in my life, it was the very best thing I did in my life. No, absolutely not.
SubhanAllah. And I was going to ask you about your family and your friends. How, you know, how was the reaction about after they knew that you became Muslim? And
well, they were not particularly happy about it, but they were not necessarily to me confrontational, except for I have several family members that don't speak to me, which is really no loss if you don't want to speak to me. But hijab was a big deal for my family to wear hijab, but you know, SubhanAllah, everything worked out, and over time, you know, when you're patient with people, they accept or at least allow you to be yourself, practice, and after a while it was okay. I had very good parents.
Now, before I go to the last question, I have something for you. Now, we did an interview before with Sister Katya, the Russian girl.
Yes, Katya.
I was just going to ask you about, of course you met her after you became Muslim. So
yes.
This is a part of your da'wah now, that you are like following up with
Inshallah.
New Muslims and things
Inshallah.
Like that. Would you tell us a little bit about how do you see other girls that they become Muslim? And you're taking in, I feel like when Katya were talking about you, she was talking about like a big mom for her, and she was like a really close friend to you. Would you like to tell us a little bit about your da'wah also?
Well, everything you do when you go out is da'wah, how you present yourself, how you speak
right.
to people. If you see people, like when I met Katya, she was at the masjid trying to get some information about Islam, and you know, you simply extend yourself. You show people that this, especially women, you know, this is the right way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I never had respect for myself until I became a Muslim and wore an hijab.
Yeah.
Because I'm free.
Right.
I'm free from the world and what the world tells you need to be. I'm free from that. So Katya, she's, mashallah, very beautiful girl, very nice girl. And she was also searching for the same thing.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
And the last thing I would ask you, what message would you give to the world?
I would ask the world, everyone in it, please, if you buy one Quran,
mm-hmm.
just read the Quran.
No, they are actually distributing for free right now. In the
Inshallah,
message, so.
They should, you know, just read, yeah. study, and search for yourself. And by doing that, perhaps your heart will open, because Allah holds the hearts of all of His creation. And He will open your heart, and He will allow you to see the truth, and inshallah, lead a very good life. Because this is just a moment, this life. Inshallah, the next is what we're all working for.
Jazakallah khair, that is just a great story that you told us.